years after Magic retired, and you know, there's all this yearning and hope.
Flea talking about the great Kobe.
But on this day today, Kobe, in death as in life, brings us all together. And the beautiful thing about sports, I just love basketball with all my heart, is that it brings everybody together. All ethnicities, all economic classes, all everybody. It's something we can all get together. And it's beautiful, like any great art form, and basketball is a great art form. And Kobe Bryant, like that kind of diligence, intelligence, craftsmanship, discipline, it's inspiring to people. It's not just losing an icon, not just losing a famous person or someone who was great. Kobe was more than that to everybody. That's why people mourn, that's why the city mourns. Kobe was an ethos. Kobe was a way of life. Kobe was an inspiration. Everybody knows Kobe got up at 4 o'clock in the morning to work out. Then he came back every season and added to his game. And we got to watch him evolve as a human being. In the beginning of his career, this like young, arrogant, intense guy. And we got to see him become kinder, more aware of the people around him, learn how to lift up his teammates, and in his retirement, to see the beauty of his love for his children and working to uplift women's basketball and all that he did, releasing children's books. All that focus was always in service of love, ultimately. And that's why we grieve, even if we don't really know. Sometimes it's like, why do I feel? I was in shock. I was weeping all day. You know, this guy just like disappears into thin air, this life force, this person who was moving along, doing so much, and then he's gone. It's a shock. It's a real shock, and we loved him, and this city will always be different, and there's will always be a big hole that no one else can ever fill.
Yeah, when I hear you explain Kobe's life, the one word that comes to mind that he was for everybody, he was medicine. He was a